Comrades, compatriots, brothers and sisters, receive profound and military revolutionary greetings on behalf of the Trade Union International of Public Service and Allied Workers, a strategic component of the World Federation of Trade Unions, WFTU. In its Directive Committee meeting held in Johannesburg, South Africa, on the 12th March 2020, the TUI Public Service and Allied took an important decision to launch its year-long program to celebrate the 75th anniversary of the founding of WFTU. In celebrating this milestone, we need to recognize the achievements made in these years of the unbroken struggle against capitalism and imperialism. Drawing lessons from the past to understand the present is key in equipping us to better shape a just and prosperous future. This lecture takes place at a time when the world is grappling with the effects of the global outbreak of the novel coronavirus. To date, more than 4 million people have been infected by this virus, and close to 300,000 people across the world have lost their lives. The world today is still grappling to find a vaccine for the virus. The impact of this virus on global economy is quite dire. The world economy is in a recession and is predicted to go into a depression even worse than witnessed in 1929. We've seen the rapid closing of companies from the air transport industry, manufacturing, textile to hospitality. No industry has been spared. The virus has already caused a series of layoffs around the world, and many workers are now waiting for government handouts in a form of different relief packages. We've also witnessed the reckless handling of the pandemic by the US, the biggest economy in the world. Over 22,000 people died in the United States, while over 19,000 people died in the UK, which records more than any other country in the world. The real face of capitalism is demonstrated in most of the development world, where we have seen big corporates putting pressure on governments to return workers back to work without putting necessary measures in place. As a result, workers get infected and die because of placing more value on profits than the lives of workers. World government and big business are levering the COVID-19 induced crisis to either undermine or suspend trade union rights and have subjected workers to untold sufferings. These prevailing harsh conditions calls for the unity of workers and the intensification of workers' struggles for their right to work and live in a just world. Throughout the world, workers are presently engaged in a struggle to defend their rights and reinstate those that have been eroded. As the TUI Public Service, we follow these struggles keenly and support them wholeheartedly. We've seen the leadership displayed by the People's Republic of China in stopping the spread of the virus in that country and sharing with the world their experiences. On behalf of the WFTU, TUI Public Service and Allied, we convey our solidarity to all families and countries affected by this virus. We also pay tribute to those frontline workers that have lost their lives fighting this deadly virus. We urge all government to act swiftly by putting in place measures that reduces the fatality rate and arrest new infections. We convene this virtual lecture as the Public Service International to join the millions of working people and their families in celebrating the 75th milestone in the history of the class-oriented, militant, and democratic international trade union movement, the WFTU. Since the founding of the WFTU in 1945, Paris, this federation has been at the forefront of advancing the working class struggles against the unjust, barbaric system of capitalism and imperialism. The record and history of WFTU in support of the struggles of the working class and the oppressed people throughout the world speaks for itself. The WFTU was on the side of the people of Vietnam when they heroically resisted the US imperialist invasion of their country. During the Cuban Revolution against the Batista puppet regime, WFTU was on the side of the victorious Cuban revolutionaries and today still support a revolution against the illegal US blockade in Chile. WFTU stood firmly with Allende and the people of Chile. In Nicaragua, it supported the revolutionary Sandinista movement. It stood by the Nepalese people's side against monarchy. In Africa, the WFTU was on the side of the people's liberation wars against dictatorship, imperialism, colonialism, and apartheid. In Iraq, in Libya, in Syria, in Venezuela, and in Lebanon, WFTU is on the side of the peoples. The WFTU has always stood and still standing with the heroic Palestinian people. WFTU and its TUI Public Service are also firmly in support of the struggles of workers in Europe, opposing the Europe Shore program that has undermined workers' right to work and earn a living. The WFTU has been consistent and principled in the struggles it has waged and supported. As we celebrate 75 years of the unwavering support of the working class by WFTU, we must remind all the progressive workers around the world of the prime objectives adopted at its founding Congress in Paris on the 3rd of October in 1945, which defined the class orientation, international working class solidarity, and the organizational outlook of the WFTU. These founding objectives are the ethos and principles that have characterized the WFTU for the past 75 years. In the second conference of the World Federation of Trade Unions, held in Milan in 1949, the World Trade Union Congress resolved to establish trade union internationals to carry out the work of WFTU in the various trade and industry branches in different countries. As the implementation arm of WFTU in the public and allied sector, the public service TUI was tasked with making the founding objective of WFTU a reality in the public and allied sectors of different countries in all regions. The TUI Public Service and Allied remains an integral and a proud sector trade union of WFTU with a history of dedication and commitment towards the objectives and program of WFTU. This lecture is not only meant to celebrate 75 years of revolutionary and militant struggles of the WFTU, but also meant to serve as an exercise to reflect on the work of our TUI and the challenges confronted with in the course of carrying out the hard work. While millions of workers from across the world have made WFTU their revolutionary home in the struggles against capitalism and imperialism, the dream of a united revolutionary international trade union movement acting in solidarity against exploitation, social injustice, monopolies, racism, and imperialism remain a dream yet to be fully realized. For as long as millions of workers remain lost in the marshlands of reactionary I2 class collaborationist unions, the progressive international trade union movement will remain at half of its full potential strength. International imperialism and the US in particular never welcomed nor accepted the birth of the anti-capitalist pro-working class spirit and character of the WFTU. They were worried about the worldwide influence of WFTU on the working class and the oppressed people. Thus, it was not surprise when, through the CIA and other secret services, and through corruption involving millions of dollars from their governments, they established a ICFTU, today known ITUC, and thus enabling the international bourgeoisie to acquire an instrument with which to divide and undermine the struggles of the international labor movement into two streams, the progressive and the collaborist streams. The above reality points to the imperative for the public service TUI and all other WFTU TUIs to increase ideological work among workers in their respective sectors to raise the class consciousness among the ranks of workers. However, ideological work cannot happen in isolation from the daily shop floor struggles of workers. We must use the daily struggles and demands of workers in the public and allied sectors for better and safer working conditions, better pay and job security as tools to educate them about the links between their problems on the shop floor and capitalism. Growing the progressive trade union movement and uniting all workers remain one of the most urgent tasks of all WFTU affiliates in the struggles against both reactionary trade unionism and capitalism. The different contexts and circumstances of our regions and countries that results from their geographies, social and cultural differences, and different levels of economic development call for a dynamic and flexible organization that can respond to the different challenges confronting its affiliates. Many of the countries of our affiliates as TUI in the underdeveloped former colonies suffer from a lack of trade union rights, low level of employment and industrialization, lack of resources due to the failure of employers to effect stop orders, or poorly paid members who are too poor to pay affiliation fees to locals and repressive undemocratic governments. This situation manifests itself in the form of weak underdeveloped trade unions that are too weak to take on challenges they are confronted with. Meanwhile, in Europe and many relatively well-developed countries, our affiliates mainly face a problem of reversal of historical gains as secure jobs get eroded, problem related to unilateral interference with the legal pensionable age, growing unemployment as a result of neoliberal globalization policies of privatization and rationalizations, cuts in public and social spending, and increasing working hours for lower pay. These developments, together with the shift of production to cheap labor destinations in the South, have undermined the relative strength and bargaining power of our affiliates in the developed countries. These challenges point to the correctness and centrality of the strategy of workers' unity and international working class solidarity in the struggles against capitalism. By joining their struggles and establishing networks of collaborations, workers can be able to stop the race to the bottom that is defined by labor deregulation and purization of workers in a vain attempt to attract so-called investment with the hope of creating jobs. What is clear today is that it is not possible to protect jobs and fight for improved working conditions only in one country or region. The fight to protect jobs and to improve working conditions must be a universal and a coordinated effort if it is to be successful. The COVID-19 has created a crisis of low demand, stagnation of production, and the collapse of global supply chains. Capitalist globalization, as we know it, is today in crisis. Those that were yesterday calling for cuts in public expenditure and a minimal role for the state in the market are complaining that governments are not pumping enough money into the economy to protect vulnerable firms and not doing enough to mitigate the social impact of the pandemic. This new reality points to the limitation and importance of the neoliberal global agenda to meet the needs necessitated by the new reality. However, the capitalists have not given up on the system of capitalism. As with all crises, capitalism is in the process of reinventing itself and adapting to the new reality. Already, there is a visible shift from many companies to position themselves to profit out of the crisis. There is a shift to investment in the pharmaceuticals, manufacturing of health supplies and information technology innovations brought about by the new demands and forms of workers emerging out of this crisis. What this must tell the left is that the revolution or demise of capitalism will not come simply because we are waiting for it and capitalism is in a crisis. Revolution will be made and brought about by our action in the course of the class struggle. This is the time for the left to unite around the world and demand that governments of the world put workers first and not make the same mistakes of the 2008 economic crisis, where billions of dollars were spent in bailing out big corporates instead of investing in public service, like building more hospitals, schools, and improving working conditions of workers. While the new situation demands individual social distancing to protect us from infection, it also calls for collective action to take advantage of the weaknesses of capitalism that have been exposed and the working class vigilance against potential of more severe austerity measures being heaped on workers and the working class in the aftermath of COVID-19 under the disguise of economic recovery. While business are showered with billions worth of money, disguised as stimulus and rescue financial packages by political elite, in addition to the billions capital is already sitting on. As we conclude, the TUI Public Service and Allied reiterates its support for the people of Cuba and the Cuban Revolution in their struggles against the unilateral, unjust, inhuman, illegal economic, financial, and commercial blockade imposed by the U.S. for more than 60 years. We therefore call upon the United States and its President, Donald Trump, to immediately lift the blockade against Cuba. It also pledged its unwavering support to the people of the Bolivarian Republic of Venezuela on their daily struggles against the imperialists supported by Colombia and the Lima group of countries working with the U.S. to overthrow the democratically elected president, Nicolas Maduro. We condemn the recent foiled terrorist plot on the 3rd of May 2020, organized by a group of counter-revolutionaries trained by the U.S. and hosted by Colombia. We demand for the lifting of illegal economic sanctions currently placed on that country by U.S. We call upon the Zionist government of Israel to end the apartheid segregation against the Palestinian people and go back to the negotiation table to find a two-state solution as suggested by the United Nations. We call upon Morocco to end the illegal occupation of Western Sahara and let the Sahrawis determine their own destiny in an independent, free, and democratic country. Long live working class internationalism. Long live WFTU. Long live TUI Public Service and Allied. Solidarity forever.